Warning, adventure activities can be extremely dangerous. Please use extreme caution when out in the elements, and if you should, go ask your mom. Now, go ahead and in.
J-Trek! Man, what a great day this is going to be today. It's about 60 going to be today, and it's going to be an incredible day. Now, what happens is every once in a while, you go to a location that, man, is special, and you don't know why exactly, you don't know why it's drawing you back, and I'm in a location today that I feel that way about. It's calling me back, and I can't really explain it, but it's a place that I have to go back into, and I had the opportunity to come back here today to Agua Fria, to a place that I believe is probably one of the most special places of anywhere that's on this mesa, and I can't explain why it called me back here, but it did. And I'm going to a place today that other people have different names for it, I'm sure, but I call it the Altar Bridge. Now, I believe this location to be kind of like an ancient library, an astronomy station, a place where spiritual things would happen, and that's, I think, a little bit about what's calling me back in. And you know, I just have to go there. I mean, I really can't explain this, but this place has a draw to it that no other where up here have I felt this. You know, probably the closest I've ever come is a place that in Gila was what I call the oasis. And because you could just feel that this was not your normal place. So I figured today, since I had time to go here, that me and you would come along and we would take our time and really see if we can experience this location at the level that it needs to be looked at. Because there's some magical things about this place that were really incredible to me. So, you know, come along as we check this out. You know, one thing about here is a lot of people want to say, well, this is the reason for this, and that's what this indicates, and this is what this doesn't indicate. The reality is we don't know what any of this is. So when I look up here, I'm like, what made that little ridge right there more special than, you know, all the rest of these ridges along here? You know, what was it that made them go, this is where we're going to put some of the most important petroglyphs that I've ever seen in Perry Mesa? You know, what is the purpose? What's the reasoning for that area? You know, and that is something that I'm not going to be able to answer, regrettably. But there was something that made this ridge more special than anywhere else. Now, one thing that I really like is, now that's my envisioning right there, but that's, you know, I've just walked across the creek and it's got kind of a natural amphitheater setting, and I can imagine them down here working or just meditating or thinking. So I can see why there would be a draw there, definitely. And this whole hillside has kind of a natural amphitheater. And Man, this is pretty awesome. I mean, can you imagine what it would have been like sitting around here 800 years ago, and this, what appears to be a Tinahas, was here, and so were the petroglyphs up the hill more, nothing more than just a great swimming hole, or did they have a spiritual value and a spiritual meaning like I think they do? No, you just don't know. But you look at these locations like this, and I mean, this would have been a paradise. There would have been so much activity going on. You know, the animals would have been coming down here. The people would have been coming down here. I mean, this would have been just a fabulous place. So when I go to these places, I want to make sure that I remember, you know, the magnificence of these locations. And this has been a beautiful spot for 1,000 years. And I'm just awe-inspired and overwhelmed at times when we come to these locations, and I'm just sitting out here in the middle of nowhere, and 60 miles away is 5 million people. And it's just me and you today. Isn't that awesome? You know, as you come along this ridgeline and you look up there, and I'm probably 30, 40 yards off this cliff face right here. And right now, if you had to judge this right now, you'd probably get, you turn around and head back to the truck and look for someplace maybe a little better. You know, one thing I'm doing is I'm carefully studying this whole ridgeline. I'm going to walk it extremely slow and systematically. I've got nothing but time because I really want to see what this really holds in store. As I go through here, you know, I'm checking these walls, and, you know, I only saw one petro down at that end, so I don't see too much stuff, which kind of goes back to, you know, they picked specific locations and they had specific meaning of some type. Whether you know what they mean or not, you know they had specific meaning and for the placement. You know that, because if not, that right there would have been the perfect wall to work, and it wasn't used. So that's pretty easy for me to say, you know, they just didn't throw it up there. They had reasonings to where, why they put what they put on the wall. And that sure looks like a number one. But I don't think it is. Let's look in that cave. That's a good place to get ourselves in a lot of trouble. Nothing really in there. I don't see. There's not a lot over here. Now, this area here has complete direct sun. Does that matter? I don't know. But it does. So as we get in here, we see a beautiful archaic design. We see a piece here. We walk through here. That is really a cool piece right there. Oh my gosh, look at there. So now, we're getting in, and so right here, okay, there's like a double sun. It's been beat in pretty well. So there is a beautiful, looks like what's a double sun with a border all the way around it. Hopefully you can see it halfway decent. It's pretty difficult in these rocks, but as we move over here, now what we're seeing is another deer similar to the deer that we saw as I worked these rock ledges. We see this archaic design and then a huge deer right there. Now I'll back up for this one in front because we'll see as I come along this ridge, we'll get down there and we'll take a look Let's see if we can deduct anything else along this ridgeline. Okay, look at that piece there. Look how beautiful that is with the wheels and the different stuff. Let's get up in there, get a good shot of that. Nice. Looks like coyotes down there. Look at that archaic piece right there, and it moves over here to there. Large deer. Look at that piece right there. So this area right here was extremely important in here. You can really see the importance of this stuff here. As I get up there, there's a nice deer in the shadows right there. And then a nice archaic piece there. Beautiful piece right there. Another shield type symbol right here. Deers. And then one of the best deers I think I have almost ever seen right there as I get up in here. And I take a look at this shield right there. Now look at that piece right there. Isn't that incredible? And then as we get through here, there is what appears to be, ooh, that's close, a stork-type creature right there. And then there is another. And then my favorite, one of my favorites is, look at the design on that as it goes up. That deer with those antlers, it's, I mean, incredible. So they have been up here, and there has to be, you know, they say the duck is a shaman. I would say if there's a sign of a shaman over here, that's it right there. It seems to be bird-type creatures. Would make more sense to me. But, you know, that's still just a guess. You know, if they got up here and they did this work, you know, look at that piece. I mean, just fascinating. Now, I tell you what, this is a special place. And then one of the most special pieces that you're going to run across anywhere is that one right there. That is the one that they think is the symbol for the supernova, which I can't say it is or it isn't. I mean, I know what they see in it, but I can't tell you that's exactly what it is because I didn't draw it, I didn't make it, I didn't peck it. But if you look at that right there, that is one of the most fabulous petroglyphs you're going to see anywhere. That is just gorgeous. This was supposed to be significant because they think that it was the supernova that happened at that time. Now, the Chinese documented that. And people believe that this is the very event taking place on this structure. Now, one of the reasons I'm here is to see significance of petroglyphs that may enforce that by, you know, the angle. Did they pick this rock here for the angle? Did they pick these rocks up here because it faces in a direction? Because it definitely seems funny that the petroglyphs are based in an area that kind of feels like it pushes out this way. And that the other structure that's a circle over here, it seems like all this is in this kind of altar, rock altar type configuration, and all of it goes this direction here, which would be southeast. And I'm just curious if that was the purpose of the structure and why this is here. It would show the power of this petroglyph if that was it. Now, what we're going to do is walk on down to an area that I really believe was the shaman's cave. Now, another thing that I'm looking at is there's no shards here. So it wasn't a place that, even though they have areas that looks like kitchens, if they were doing a lot of work like that, there would have been absolutely shards. And I don't see any. So that tells me that this was not a place that, and that's what I believe to be the shaman's cave in there. There's granite stones all over. There's mortars all over. But the funny thing was, you don't see a ton of pottery shards. Now they worked this one here. They worked all these. They worked these here. And then our little cave outcropping, which, you know, is pretty cool. A lot of animals found home. That was really a busy structure right there. Now you wonder how he got up there to do that. Was he working that stone there? Or did it fall off here? Kind of looks like it did. You know, I don't know. Look there, those grinding areas there. Another stone right there that's really been ground. Right here, look at that. Those are all over. Now this would be a perfect area to find shards if they were using stuff as shards. You know, if they are using pots here, but you don't see them. That's a great area in there. There's the eyeball. They were definitely up there, however they got there, if it was from the top down, which I'm starting to guess, as they walked in right here, stepped in there. Oh yeah, look at that one up there that I never saw. That deer up in that point. So we might have to go up there and take a gander at that. Oh, and then they start to run out and you're like, okay, this area definitely had significance. Look at this one here. I never saw this one. Let's take it easy and get over there. Take your time. Look at that. Look at that. What do you guys think it was? What do you think this signified? What do you think that any of this stuff was? As far as, you know, do you think I'm right? You think I'm wrong? You think we're on a place? Think we're not at a place? You believe me? What's your thought process? Here, another area. I love those little men right here. You know, what do I think of? Well, there's a man that was in there. That was another shaman cave, or the original shaman cave, but no pottery. No shards at all in here. So, and this is a place that I don't think got abused. So most people don't know where this is at. So it wasn't overworked. So if they were using pottery shards up here, they would have been up here. Now, I found something that I find totally intriguing that actually is really exciting. Now look at that one, isn't that nice? This rock here is pretty well covered. Before we go up, we'll take a look down here. Take a look at that. That's a nice rock right there. Nice rock. But I see something that's really grabbed my attention. Look right here. Look at this. Isn't that interesting? Those rock walls up there. But here's what's got me. Is this deer here, these two here, look like they were red at one time. Absolutely look like they were red. Now they do stuff a little different. They paint, they just don't, they do a petroglyph and then they paint the petroglyph. They don't paint the design. So there's no doubt in my mind that these two deers were red. And this is the first time I have seen anything over here in this area that looks like they were red, because they were in direct sun. You know, none of the rest of these look like that. Nice little guy right there. Now, one other thing's kind of got me intrigued. You know, these rocks right here that I'm stepping on, I guarantee you they put them there. That hole right there kind of intrigues me. You know, as you're walking along this, you find weird stuff, and that's definitely a weird rock right there. Fits right in that groove, isn't that funny? It's in there perfect. It's kind of funny. I'm up on the top of the ridge now. You know, this definitely was a special place. And I mean, as I look down here from above, man, you see all kinds of grinding holes, and they're everywhere. So they did work here, but they didn't have pots. They didn't break pots here, which is really kind of funny when you look at it. You try to figure this stuff out, and you know, there's got to be some reasoning behind all this, right? And figure out, you know, just what this means. So what I'm going to do is we're going to just take a walk. We're going to take a minute, and I'm just going to be quiet, and just we're going to walk this ridge for a minute or two, and then just kind of take a look and suck this in and soak it in and see if you can figure out what this was about, and think about what you want to do in your life and how your life is going and what changes maybe you have to make. You know, because eventually whatever we've done is just going to be writings on the wall, and you know, we're going to be gone. And so, you know, what do you want to make on your mark before you leave here? So let's take a look, and we'll take a walk, and we'll take a minute. And I want to appreciate you for coming along. And man, if you get a chance, please subscribe, please like, please hit the notification bell. That means that when a video comes out, we do post every Monday and Thursday. So if you like this content, leave me a message.
You know, we also have Black Flag Expedition, which is our Facebook page. If you'd like to join it. And if you go on adventures, man, I want to see yours just as well. Maybe you got some great places I'd love to go, and that's awesome. You can also message me. And we appreciate you. If you want to donate a little gas here and there, I'm not going to bitch, and I'm not going to tell you no. So, Jay Shrek, Black Flag Expeditions. Look at this. And this is out there for everybody to go see. All you got to do is... get in the car. Man, it better be the truck on this trip.